Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be going over the lowest of low grade e-waste. It's easy pickings to me. This was RJ45 connectors, about 350. They were cut off with clines. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna put them into this AP station and go after the gold. We're gonna dissolve the base metals and then go see what we have. All right, so we're gonna just use muriatic acid or hydrochloric acid. And there's a little teeny tiny piece of copper wire in there. And we're gonna make our own copper two etchant. All right, so there you go. I'm gonna put it in the cat litter box and we're gonna route the air tube through a hole and we'll crank this up. There's a bird's eye view of the station. Like I said, we'll be starting this up shortly and check it in a couple of days. All right, so I will be using this gasket tape to fill in the hole and to make it not airtight, but you know, pretty good to keep the vapors at a minimum, and we'll be running our hood. So, you know, kind of like to keep the mess a little bit under control because the splash is so much, but we're getting there. All right, so it's been about 5 days. We're slowly starting to dissolve some of the base metals. You can see there we have some gold foils floating and there are some flakes that are starting to form. I feel like let's put this in the larger volume of copper two etchant. It's got plenty of ferrous or ferric chloride in it to attack the base metals. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna add it to the larger volume and let those base metals get dissolved. So we're going to put it in here and check in a couple of days. So here's a better example of the gold foils that are coming off. You can see it's really starting to work. There's several flakes and foils in there. So I will capture that in a filter and we'll process it all at the same time. You'll have to pardon the noise, but the fume hood's on. I think we've attacked most of the base metals, or rather dissolved most of the base metals. We're going to put a little water in here and stir it around and then see how the foils, if they float, or just get a general feel for how it's going. So this here is just recycled rinse water. No sense in making, oh yeah, look at that. Pretty much done. We'll stir it around and see how that works out. Alright, time to put some circuit boards in there next. Looks pretty good to me. We're going to decant this off. So, a lot of those foils are coming out of there. We'll filter this off right here and then reuse the water again. That's not bad. It's just a little bit, but it, you know, it's recovered. The whole point of this is it would have gone to the landfill. You know, we're going to recycle it. So a little bit of urban mining today. Man, I kind of like the look of that. I'm not, it's kind of fun, you know? It's starting to get late. I'm going to put this in acid peroxide solution. I know it's got a little tin in it, but I really don't feel like pre-soaking it in hydrochloric acid. I'll just burn the filter papers and deal with any of that tin oxide to cover up a little bit of sludge and then process by the region drop with ferrosulfate and just the backside. You know, low grade pins. We're eventually going to move up to higher grade pins, but I got to get this stir rolling. So we're going to put this into the acid peroxide solution and check it in a couple of days. Well, I have to say, using that sodium parasulfate worked pretty well. Pretty much all the foils are off this. A
of our dog coils. Got one. We'll give it another day. Tuck it away, check it again tomorrow. I'm pretty sure we'll be ready. We'll recover that gold. There's all the foils.
So we're going to separate the printed circuit board gold waste from the foils. I'll filter out the AP solution. And we'll recover the gold foils, but we're going to do that off camera. I'll set up my filter, and then we'll come back with the results. All right, so we're losing a little bit of daylight here. Here's the filter set up. We're going to filter the solution in that Ohlmeyer flask and then return it to the bucket. There's a little bit of foils that I washed off from the circuit boards that I missed. I'll use that to rinse that filter out, and we'll reuse the copper to etchant rinse water. We're going to rinse the filter out with the water that I had washed the printed circuit boards off. There's a little bit of gold, so once we rinse this filter out, we'll put that in our filter storage for this project. So this here is my copper 2 etchant slash AP, but I never use peroxides. I don't call it AP. Anyway, you can see the nice green color it's supposed to be. Ours is a little darker right now because of the base metals it's in. I suspect there's a little bit of iron, some tin, and definitely a lot of copper. But I'm going to put it in the storage for now because it's clean. All right, so we are going to the woodshed. I'm going to add some muriatic acid slash hydrochloric acid, enough to cover, and then I'll add a cap full of bleach for the strong oxidizer, and we'll come back and check this. I gotta get this gold dropped for the weekend, so I'm not burning the paper filters. I got a little bit of plastic in there. I'll just filter this solution out and drop with ferrous sulfate, and we'll have to, you know, obviously clean it up with sulfuric acid and hydrochloric acid and water baths and purify it a whole bunch of times. So here we go. We've covered it, and we'll check it in the morning, actually when I get off work. So it's covered. We're going to let it work its magic of the muriatic acid and bleach, and then we'll drop it with, like I said, ferrous sulfate, and we'll have to do a couple of refinings on this. I know it's just a small amount, but if we want pure gold, we've got to do it correct, especially if I'm skipping the burning of paper filters. All right, so this is another little project where we used an AP to recover, but there's still a little bit in there. So I am going to add a little muriatic acid and just mainly maybe a milligram of nitric acid to make aqualesium that we've got to tighten this up too. So here we go. Alright, so that might be 1.5 to 2. I definitely don't want to overdo it. We'll take that outside, let that cook for a couple of days, and then check it. I know there's a little bit of copper in it, probably a little bit of more base metals, but we'll roll with it. So the solution on the left is the hydrochloric acid and bleach. It's dissolving the foils away pretty good. And that is the aquaregia. Man, that stuff's looking pretty dirty. I think I'm gonna have to add just a little bit more nitric. You can see we haven't dissolved all the gold foils, but we have attacked the base metals, so there wasn't that much. I didn't think it was going to get that dirty, but you know, lesson learned. So we'll back out, and it's a little less than 24 hours. So this is the RJ45 connectors and a couple of telephone connectors. In the background, that's the low-weight gold waste. They're really both low-weight gold waste, but one was processed using hydrochloric acid and bleach, and this one here is we're trying to get the remnants of the gold that's in the fingers here, or the slots. And so what I did was I mixed up some aqua regia and had to add to it, because you know I still had a little bit of gold floating on top, and you can see the reaction starting to take off. So we'll let that work its magic and come back, and we're going to drop the gold today. This is going on 2 weeks now of processing, so I'd like to get some results. All right, so the case of where'd the mystery gold go? Here it is here. It didn't take long to go into solution, and when I stannous chloride tested, look at that, man. That is some, there is the gold. And man, I cannot explain that. This, maybe this solution was heavy in copper, I don't know, and it caused it to cement out. But you can see even cotton filtering the last of the filter, the solution, there's still a little. So when I'm finished, I'll put that in there, and we'll drop it today with, I guess, S&B, since I'm out of ferrous sulfate. Well, I have a little left, but I don't know if it's enough to do both of them. We'll see. All right, so we're going to add the plug to the solution, and we'll drop with S&B shortly. All right, I add a little bit of sulfuric acid to that to drop out any lead, and we will filter that right now. All right, let's do this. We're getting ready to drop the gold that was recovered with hydrochloric acid and bleach. Oh, that stuff stinks. Now, there's our color change. All right, there's a little gold at the bottom there. I'll probably let this settle tonight, man. I'm always so impatient, but we're starting to see some results. I'll see if I can lift that up for you. It's pretty hot. I'll let that cool. Well, maybe a quarter of a gram, maybe a little more. We'll see. We'll dry it up. The whole point was, you know, this was going to the landfill, and you know, we recovered it, so didn't spend that much on chemicals, maybe $10 or $12, but we'll see. Okay,